Okay, so today we will start talking about classes. Okay? Or actually, we are going to start talking about object-oriented programming. This is, we are now starting the course, this course. Because what structures are from the previous course, functions, strings, pointers, all those files, all of those topics are from previous course. Object-oriented starts with classes. But structures are good bridge to, yani, to classes. We start from class structures, then we go to classes. They are similar. For example, here, you see here, we'll use the same, example that we used before. So we said, for structure, we say struct car and what we have integer, year, char, name or model, I think model, let's say 30, okay, and then float, price. And then we do it this way. This is a structure. So what is a class? A class, how to define? First, I'll let you, so you can see the difference between this one and this one. Okay, or normally we say public class or class car. This is the only change. This is the only change. So why we have two things, Yani? It is the same thing. Why we have two things? Huh?
More
properties for class. Yeah, there are more things. We'll talk about more things about classes. But actually, the nature of structures and the nature of classes are different. Okay? Structures, you know, when we talk about programming, we call structural programming. Structural programming. We are talking about programs that are structures into, sometimes we call them functional programming, or sequential programming. This is the type, the type of programs we used before or till now. But for classes, we are starting to talk about object-oriented programming. Structures and objects. Objects, classes, we'll talk about them. They are almost the same. We'll talk about them. When we say objects and classes, almost the same. There are some differences. Objects and structures are different. When we define a structure, the name of the structure is what? Is considered what? Huh? A data type, yes. It is a new data type, a new type in C++. The same way, a car, here a class, which is named car, is also a type. So we can create new types in C++ using what? Using structures or using classes. So now you have, all the way to define whatever you want of types. How many types we can define? No limit. The same with structure. I mentioned a type doesn't take anything from memory, doesn't take space in memory. It is just a definition. But and also for classes, the same way. It is just a definition. As I mentioned, it is like the sketch you do for when you want to build a house. You go there and get from the engineer a sketch, okay, for the house. That sketch is on paper. It is not the actual house. The same thing here. The structure and the class are only just like sketches. They are not, there is no existence for them in the program or in memory. But now, till now, everything is the same. Till now, everything is the same. So let's say, if I want to define a variable of type, let's say here, let's call it this one, 1. So we will make it different so you'll not get confused. Yani. Let's define a variable of type car1. So I say car1, for example, my car. Then how to define a variable of type car2? The same way, car2, my car, for example, 2. This, let's say, call it 1. Here, this one we call it 1. This one, 2. The same way. As you see, till now, it is the same. One little difference that from this what I defined till now. This we call a car structure, or a my car one structure. We call some when we talk about it, we say my car structure or a car structure. But this one we call it object. So you see here the difference between a class and object. A class is the definition. A class is the definition. Object is the variable that we define or declare from that class, from that type. So this is a class, this is an object. This is an object. Okay, now I told you before that car1 is a type. It has no place in memory. But my car1 is a structure or a physical place in memory. It reserves some place, it takes some space in memory. And we can put values into these members. We can put values into these members. Okay? So there is a space in memory, a place in memory. It's called my car1, and it takes, for example, 38 bytes. The same way here, car2 is just a definition. It's a type. My car2 is also has space in memory. It has like a C++ reserve 38 bytes for my car2. So we'll have my car1, my car2. This is structure. This is object. Okay. So now almost the same. Still almost the same, except that I mentioned the name. This is, we call it a car structure. Okay, but this one we call it a car object or an object. Anything that we define from classes, out of classes, we are objects. But there is a big difference. There's a big difference. This one, we call it static. This one, we call it dynamic or alive. What does this mean? This means that my car one is just there in memory, a place in memory where you change the values of year, model, just a place there where you change the values of the members, of the structure members. But my car two is now an object. What does that mean? It means that is something that we see and touch and feel. It is not just a place in memory. It is that has actions, that can do things. I'll explain this in Arabic. يعني my car one عبارة عن مكان في الميموري فقط نخزن فيه بيانات وبس ما يسوي أي شغل ما ممكن يكون ذيك البيانات تتغير بطريقة معينة من ذاتها أو يلها تأثير على غيرها ولا شيء ما ممكن لكن my car two عبارة عن object يلها حياة يلها فعل تقدر تقوم بأشياء لنفسها ولغيرها هذا المقصود بالأوبجكت ولما نقول على أنها دائما ستاتيك يعني ثابتة ما تتغير دايناميك يعني متجددة طول وقتها تتجدد في أي لحظة من اللحظات تكون يعني حالتها مختلفة عن اللحظة اللي قبلها ونقول على أنها alive يعني لها حياة يعني فيها حياة بحيث تقوم بأعمال So this is the difference. Static means just a place in memory where we put data for the members, for the structure members. The members don't do any action. This variable here doesn't do any action. But this one, it does actions. It can do things for itself or for others. Later on, you will see that this object will talk to some other objects. يعني بعض الobjects بتتخاطب مع الobjects الثانية. بيصبح لها حياة عاد كل واحدة تتخاطب مع الثانية. So each object will talk to other objects. It can change its state. Its state يعني معناه إن حالتها. So it can change its state. That's why we say it is dynamic. Its state is continuously changing. Okay? So, this is what we say objects. But what are examples of objects? What are examples of objects? Anything you see or you touch, and sometimes there are physical objects. Physical objects, those that we see. I see this one. I can touch this one. I can wrap this one. This is an object. This mouse is an object. This telephone is an object. This one an object. This one an object. This is an object. This is an object. The air is an object. This one an object. The air condition is an object. The ceiling is an object. The floor is an object. The wall is an object. Anything you see or touch or feel, you can call objects. So this is what we. This is why object oriented is very, 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 very important. They invented object oriented methodology or techniques late 80s, at the end of 1980s. Before, they cannot do things. It's only just procedural programming, or they call it functional programming. There, in that, what they do, they write a program, they write main, for example, the main function, and if they have new things they want to do to add, they create another function. They need another things to do, they create another function. That way it's called functional programming. It is the building block, يعني الأساس اللي يبنى منه البناء البرنامج. The function, the building block there is functions. If you want to make your program bigger and bigger and bigger, just add functions, 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 functions. But in object-oriented programming, the building block is
class.
Now, if you want to expand your program, create a class. Want to add things? Create a class. Okay? So, I'll try to give you any differences between what's object-oriented and also some of the terminologies, مصطلحات, about object orientation. Okay? So now, as you see, also sometimes objects are not just physical. Physical means I can touch or see or feel or whatever. And this is physical, we call it physical. Sometimes it is conceptual. Conceptual. What does conceptual mean? It means concept. So, for example, advising. Advising. And academic advising. Is it physical? يعني الإرشاد الأكاديمي. يقدر واحد يروح لمكان معين ويحصله موجود جالس ولا شيء ويقدر يشوفه ولا يلمسه ولا شيء الارشاد الأكاديمي موجود ها موجود الارشاد الأكاديمي ما المرشد الأكاديمي المرشد الأكاديمي طبعا صندوق موجود هناك في المكتب زين so academic advising you cannot see you cannot it is just a concept. It is just a concept. Absence warnings, or absence itself. Is it physical? You see it? Oh, this is absence one. You see it, يعني, you can touch it, you can take it, put it in your pocket or something. No, it is just a concept. Means that one day you didn't come to class, so you are recorded absent. So it's just a concept. This is what we call. Sometimes also, like قوانين, يعني قانون مثل الفيزياء ولا غيره. So all these laws of physics, or even rules of C++, or these are concepts. These are concepts. You can convert all of these to classes. So you can have a class called academic advising, okay? You can have class called registration. Registration is a process. It is just a process. You do this, then this, this, then this, then this, then this. It is a process, okay? So you can have classes of these things. So this is what we call objects. So objects can be physical or conceptual or sometimes a process آلية يعني. Okay. These are some differences about terminologies, يعني مصطلحات. But actually, in C++, what's the difference? For example, I declare car 1 like this. And I declare my car 1 as this. And I declared my car 2 as this. As I said, this is object, this is a structure. Okay. Now, what is that also, what are differences? Suppose if I want to put value for year here, how can I put value into year in my car 1? How can I put the value? Huh? Equal? Just equal? Year equal? Year equal? Huh? Car 1? Car 1 dot? Year? Equals? 2018. Okay. This is? This is type. This is a type. Yani, we cannot say int equals 5. You cannot say int equals 5. And you cannot do this. A type equals 5. This is a type, a definition only. You cannot do this one. You are manipulating the physical things, the one that has some place in memory, which is my car 1. My car 1. So this is how we put values into the members of the structure. Now, what if I want to put a value here for how to put a value here for year in car in my car 2. So I say my car 2 year equals 2018. Well, this is the way it is in C++, yes. This is the way it is in C++. For structure, this is how I do it. For classes or objects, this is how I do it. Any difference? It looks the same, صح? Well, this will be accepted by the compiler. This will generate an error. It will generate an error. Why? Well, the problem is that the way classes are defined and the way structures are defined. Okay? I bring a box. Okay? I bring two boxes and I put some things inside this box and few things inside this box. Okay? When I bring them here, you can see what is inside? Yeah? You cannot see what is inside? يعني نجيب كرتون هنا، كرتون هنا وكرتون هنا. حط فيهم أشياء. نقدر نشوف اللي فيهم داخل؟ ما نقدر؟ ها؟ Open. They are open. They are open. For example, let's say they are closed, not open. If they are open, no problem. You can see here, you can see here. But what if they are closed? Both of them are closed. You will not be able to see. Okay? What if one of them is made of glass? The other one is made of whatever, wood, for example. You can see both?
No.
You can see the one made of glass?
Yes.
Okay, but not the other one, sir? Okay, this is the idea. Structures are boxes made of glass. Made of glass. You can see inside. You can change inside, whatever there. So this is okay. You can do this one. Glasses, structures by default are public. By default, they are public. Okay? But classes, by default, are private. By default, are private. So you cannot, it means, what does that mean, private? It means you cannot look inside. You see here, you have the box, this is the box. This is, you are trying to look inside. What is there inside? You have year, you have model, you have price. Ah, you want to look inside and you want to change. You cannot do. You cannot do. But we want to change. Why we cannot do? We want to change, Amina. How can I give a value to year if I cannot change it? I need to go inside, sir. Okay. So by default, these are public. It's called like this. Structures. This one, by default, are private. Private. By default, يعني بالمفترض يعني اللي يعني متعارف عليه إني لما نعرف أي كلاس مباشرة أي شيء داخله يعتبر private. هذه نقول by default. So when you define a class, anything by default, anything inside it is private. You cannot see. But this one, of course, in classes, in structure, we don't normally do this one. We don't do, because it is public, we don't do it, we don't write it. But in classes, if you don't write it, it will be private. If you want to make it public, this is we call access modifier. Access modifier. Okay, so we call it access modifier. And I want to modify. So this is how to allow me to modify how I can access the class or the objects. So if I don't want it to be private, I can say public. How to write a access modifier? You write the word private or public, and then a colon, and then put whatever you want later after it. Okay. Now, if I put it this way, if I write it this way, for example, like public here, then I can do this. I can do this. The compiler will not object to it. But for classes, it is not recommended that we do this as private. What we call these? We call them data members or class members. Okay? But normally we call them attributes, خصائص. This one here, does it have any attribute? Yes. It has weight, it has size, it has color, it has maybe some other properties. Yes, kind of the metal or the material it is made of, the shape. These are attributes. So each object has attributes. Okay, so here, I have here, this is one paper, this is one paper. Okay, أعطيني واحدة من الأسايمنت. Okay, so this I have now. I have, يعني, two sheets of the assignment. Are they the same? Huh? They are the same. So, the same size, the same content, the same color, the same thing. But in reality, في الواقع في الحقيقة, are they the same? Is this paper?
No.
If I am, now I am moving this paper, does that mean I am moving this paper? This is object. This is a different, they are the same attributes, huh? The same properties, we call them sometimes properties, the same thing. But they are different. Each object has what we call identity. We call it identity. يعني هوية. متماثلين في كل شيء لكن كل شيء مختلف عن الثاني. هذا لما أتكلم يعني على مثلا على هذا مثلا الشخص متشابهين كل حاجة لكن هذا الشخص غير عن هذا الشخص. هذا هويته غير هذا هويته غير يعني مثل ما قلنا بالنسبة للورق. So these are what we call the properties of objects. Objects has attributes or properties, sometimes we call them. They have identity. Okay, that's the properties of the characteristics or the values where we store values. And also, you see, this paper here, it moves, or sometimes it can fly. Okay? They can do actions. Objects, they can do actions. For example, can this talk? Can we talk?
Yes.
We are objects. Okay? Do I talk the same way you talk? No. We talk. But objects, normally, they do actions. And their actions little bit different sometimes from object to object. So in object orientation, objects have these main three properties. Each object has identity, each object has properties or attributes, which are these ones here. These are the members that we call them, the data members or class members. And they do actions. They do actions. Okay? How they do actions? How do they do actions? Normally, we do this one here. We make it private. Normally it is private, okay? But we make the actions public. Public, for example, print. void print. This is, for example, one of the actions that can this object do. They can print, for example, their attributes, the values. If I want to ask this object, what is your birthday, for example, for persons, for people? What is your weight? What is your height? What is your major? What is your address? What is your name? What is your telephone number? What is it? This is, this print will give us these the values of these attributes. This is what we call, action. Action normally is public. So for example, for people, they talk. Okay, is this private or public? Can any, for example, for you, can others can hear you talking? Huh? They cannot, you don't talk to people? You are talking now, I hear you. So this is public, means I am another object, you are another object. When you talk, I can hear. So it means public. But there are some private attributes, خصائص. كل واحد عنده خصائص. صح؟ يعني ما نقدر نسأله عن هذا الخصائص إيش هو وإيش كده يعني. زين؟ So these are private. That's why we put the members or the attributes private. The actions, we put them public. Sometimes we put members, put them also public, because no harm in people, they know about them. And for actions, sometimes also, normally we put them public, but sometimes also we put them private. We put them private. We'll explain this more later on. Yani, this is just an introduction to classes, yani, how you define a class, what's an object, how they differ from structures. Normally they are almost the same, but now we are starting to do things that we didn't do with class, with structures. Structures are only storage places where you put data. Classes will create from them objects. And objects can talk, walk, run, they can do actions. And they have also properties or attributes. Okay, any question about this? By the way, the quiz will be inshallah next week on Wednesday in the lab. Okay, next week on Wednesday. Huh? I'll tell you next week. I'll tell you next week, not now. Because maybe some of these what we are talking about we might be there in the quiz. Okay. Any question about this one or the assignment or anything? Yes? No. The car 2 is the class. Car 2 is the class. My car 2 is the object. Class is definition, only the definition. Class is only definition. The object is the one doing the real work. Okay? يعني in Arabic, I'll explain in Arabic. يعني مثلا السيارة يجي معها manual. اللي هي يجي معها ولا الماكينة اللي نشتريها ولا شيء. هذه المانيوال تشرح كيف طريقة تشغيلها وتصليحها وكذا. هذه بس الكلاس نفس الشيء، هذه الأشياء اللي في داخل عبارة عن مانيوال تشرح كذا، بس الفعل الحقيقي للشغل تكون بالسيارة نفسها، ما المانيوال. Yes, all, this is a good question, and all objects of the same class normally will do the same action. The same action. Normally, all objects of the same class do not, the attributes will be different. The properties will be different. But the actions, normally, they are the same. Okay? Things will be clear later on. This is just starting. طيب anything